Hello, how you doing? That was so random. But oh yeah, like who is excited for Friends reunion, you guys? Like I see all Instagram posts here and there about it happening, and I'm like, yes, I'm ready. Like it's kind of, if not the most favorite show on this planet. And after 15 years, a reunion is something I'm like, I'm waiting for it. So, anyways, this is the first video I'm filming after I hit 15,000 on YouTube. So, thank you so much for 50,000 subscribers. It means the absolute world to me. I'm forever grateful that you guys are watching my videos, enjoying them, appreciating them. It just means the world to me. Coming to today's video, so there is this makeup look I always do. Like, this is my go-to makeup look. Anytime I have to go out and I want to do makeup, this is the thing I do. It is super simple and super easy, and whenever I post about it on Instagram, everybody's like, can we get a tutorial? It is as basic as it can get, like so basic. It literally takes me, like, if I have to do properly with precision, etc., it'll take me like 20 to 30 minutes to do. If I'm in a rush, I can finish it in 10 to 15 minutes. Also, really depends on my mood, and I just do things according to what suits my face, and I feel like very put together at the end of it. So yeah, let's get started. So first things first, skin prep is very important before you go in with makeup. So I already applied my moisturizer and sunscreen a while ago. Of course, don't apply sunscreen if you're going out in the night, but in the morning I do apply it. And then I'm going in with this Smashbox primer water, and I drench myself in it. So it's been some time that I applied my moisturizer, so this just helps hydrate the skin more. Next, I'm going in with this e.l.f. putty primer. Just, you know, use it in this area and on my nose, where I have little bit of pores so that they get filled. So I did review this primer and I liked it, but I don't know why I never reached out to it again. But recently I've been using this a lot and it does make a difference. Like, if when I don't apply this and I go in with foundation, I can see my pores, tiny itty bitty ones. But when I use this and I go with primer, it's kind of more flawless. So for foundation, I'm going in with these two foundations. NYX one is a little darker to me, and Maybelline Fit Me is tiny bit lighter. Like, I directly go with that also sometimes if I'm like too lazy, but today I have time, so I'm just going to mix these two. Okay, now before going in with foundation, there's something I do, especially because it is a summer. Now, of course, we're not going out anywhere, but you know, just futuristic purposes, I'm mentioning it right now that, like, I'm combination oily skin girl, so I kind of get oily throughout the day, especially in summer because it's so hot and you know, you sweat, etc. So what I do is I take my translucent powder and I dab on the areas where I usually get oily. So this and this is the region I usually tend to get oily, so I'm lightly going to dab that powder with a brush. Now you can use a sponge to do it as well, but be a little light-handed. If you want to see like properly how to do this, I have a video on this for like makeup for oily skin types. Foundation is on my hand and I'm going to just apply that. Now you can see that I applied the foundation only on my cheek. That is because this is the area where I have like acne scars, etc., and the rest of the area is really like, I mean, I don't have any blemishes or discoloration majorly. So a light layer of foundation to just even everything out would be enough. But this is the area where I need a little bit more coverage. And this is like a more soft glam look I'm going for. I want it to look very soft and natural. So I don't want to go really overboard with the foundation. I want to use as minimal product as possible. And so the foundation is only in this area. And I'm going to take a brush. This is the Real Techniques 204 Buffing Brush. It's a really good foundation brush. So I'm going to take it and first concentrate this foundation only in this area, because I want to first make sure I cover my acne scars up before I go with this on the rest of the face. So I just start buffing it, and you can see my hand, I'm like patting like this, I'm not rubbing it, so that the product is nicely blended into the skin and adds more coverage there. When I pull, what happens is the coverage moves away, the foundation gets lifted, etc., and we do not want that. So take my hand moment, I'm just buffing, 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 buffing. You can see that little bit of foundation kind of really covered everything very nicely, and I'm going to do the same thing on the other hand as well, other side as well, not on the other hand. So you can see that this side and this side got covered up really well. It even covered like the entire cheek area while covering the scars as well. So whatever is left on the brush, or you can take a little bit more, like tiny bit more, and just add on the rest of the face. Now, I usually always get this question that why don't you apply foundation on the forehead? Again, same reason, like I have a naturally bronzed forehead. It's a little darker than my face and I love bronzing my forehead. So it does not make sense for me to add a ton of foundation on it and then go bronze it. You can see distributed very, very evenly on my entire face and it just looks really nice. If you have some discoloration or something, you can of course go ahead with, like, you know, color correction first and then go ahead with foundation. Next, for concealer, I'm going in with this LA Girl Pro HD concealer, and again tiny bit. You have to make sure you don't add too much. So now, concealer is something, depends on my mood. Like if I'm going for something which is extremely like natural look, then I add very less concealer. But if I want a little more glam, where I want to do a little bit of eye or etc., I just add a tiny bit more concealer so that it just looks a little more highlighted. Next, I'm again going in with this contour brush from Real Techniques, but I really like this for my concealer. So you can of course go in with a brush or sponge, whatever you want. I'm just, like, you know, going to take this and again pressing motions. You can see I'm not swiping it. Make sure you have time. Like, I know people, like whenever I'm guiding people, they'll be like, okay, tap bole to, they'll be like 1, 2. Again, you know, don't do that. Tap matlab 1, 2, 3, 4. Literally count. If you are impatient, then at least count. Take like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Like you can see I'm still here after 10 also. And then now I'm moving to this side and blending this. Understood? Have patience when you're doing makeup. If you do in a hurry and you want it to look good, it's not going to happen. You have to have the time and patience to see how to place things and how everything is going to look on your face. See, again, still here. I'm again only buffing it here. Buff, 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 buff. It's like woof, 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 woof. I want a dog. Then go ahead again, take your foundation brush and make sure the two ends are perfectly blended. You don't want to know where your concealer is ending and where your foundation is starting. Don't take any extra foundation. The brush is enough. And blended. So I'll just take a little more concealer and I'm going to add it right here. So when you look at my face, you can see that I have this, whatever that thing is called, going on. And I kind of want to highlight that area so that it does not look so much hollow, if that makes sense. Of course, not everybody is going to have this on their face, but I'm showing it on me, so I'm going to show you what I do. I'm going to take this tinier brush and I'm blending that in that area. It is also a part of nose contouring. Once you blend it out, then you can go ahead roughly just tap the foundation brush on that so that it's kind of evenly blended. Next, I'm going in with my Laura Mercier translucent setting powder, one of my favorite powders ever on this planet. Now of course all the products can be different, like it's not necessarily like I only go with these products. I use any different products whichever is available at that time and I do the same look. It's just that the technique is same and the products may differ. So I'm going to go in with a sponge and take this powder. Cause again, if you want to see how to stop creasing, then I have a video on that as well. So just go with a light layer of the powder on the entire face as well. So just a very light layer. I took little to nothing and I just dabbed it on the entire face so that it's kind of like the foundation is not sticky anymore, like I cannot feel it when I touch it. Next step is bronzer, which is my favorite step of all time, and I'm going in with the Benefit Hoola bronzer. So I'm taking a fluffy brush. This is a random brush I got of Shein like years and years ago. Apply it on the cheekbone and a little bit below it. I don't apply it here, just does not suit my face and I don't like how it looks. Again, on the forehead, I brush the bronzer into my hairline so that kind of looks really even. You don't want your hairline to look white and your forehead to look dark, right? So take that and push it into your hairline. Same thing again on the cheekbone and a little bit below on my jaw. And a little bit on the nose. I just bronze up the nose entirely. Then I go in with a tinier brush and I add precision a little more on the top part. And then again, I'm going to go in back with a fluffier brush, kind of blend everything together. You don't want nose contour to look extremely harsh. Next, I'm going in with blush, and this is one of the blushes I've been obsessed with recently. This is the K Beauty matte blush in the shade Sugar Candy. It is such a beautiful shade. Again, I'm using a random sheen brush, but it's a more like angled brush, so it kind of fits well on my cheek. And I'm just going to go there, and I'm applying again on my cheekbones. I love this shade. It's so pretty. Like, you see, it just blends into my skin so well. I love this shade. So beautiful. It's that perfect balance between pink and peach. Next for brows, I'm going in with this ColourPop brow pencil. I just, you know, kind of even out the startings, kind of give like tiny strokes. I don't really do much for my brows. It's just that I brush them up really well, so that they, you know, kind of don't look very droopy, and fill them in the starting and make it look even, because I feel like one side of my brow is a little more bald compared to the other side. Randomly just give random strokes, brush it up, and that's about it. Now, I've been really liking like using a brow gel with it. So I just fill the starting, and the rest I use this. So this is a mascara plus a lash. Sorry. It's a mascara plus a brow mascara. So it's basically a lash mascara plus a brow mascara. And I'm going to lightly take the ending and brush my brows through it, so that they kind of stay in place and they get set very well. Or whatever concealer you used on your under eye, go in with the same thing. Now, I actually applied a lot. I usually don't apply so much. I take little bit. I kind of got carried away. Like how much I put on one eye, I kind of put that on both the eyes. So be a little mindful. Again, carve your brows, because it does make a huge difference. And just like lifting the brow, do you already see the difference? Because it's highlighted under the brow, this brow looks a lot more sharper, neater compared to the left one. So go ahead and clean that brow. I'm using Real Techniques again. Wow, I'm using so many Real Techniques brushes. This is their Deluxe Crease Brush. I've been using this for years and years and years. I really like this for concealer. So I'm going in again back with my bronzer. I'm going in with the Hoola bronzer. I'm taking a fluffier brush. This is the BH Cosmetics Studio Pro brush in number 5. And I'm going to add that in the lid. Now, of course, if you want like a more natural look, you can kind of skip concealer and like use your natural color on your eyelid and make it like more exaggerated. But I just like to go in with concealer and do it, so that I have more control about how it looks. So I take the edge and I kind of lift it until my brow, so that, you know, this part of my face is lifted in this manner. Like usually people like, you know, go till here and blend the crease color, right? But I don't do that. I blend it upwards and inwards. Same thing on the other side, going to the brow and blending that out. You can see that bronzer just added so much color to the lid. Very soft and subtle, but it's there, it's giving dimension, and it looks really nice. I'm just taking a tinier brush. I'm going to put my lower lash line with it as well. I do actually have one more video where I show you like my complete transformation. Like that video is like when I want to do photo shoots, or when I want to like, you know, film videos, or on days like when there's an event I want to go to and I want to like super glam. That's what the look I go for, which is like proper contour, highlight, makeup. Like I called it a potato transformation. I link that here. So that's when I want to do like that extra glam. It's kind of similar, but this one is like a lot less product, lot less effort. If you look at my eyes now, you can see like, you know, they're nice and lifted. The lower lash bronzer is also going up, the crease is also lifted up, so my eyes look a lot more awake and lifted, and I really like how that you know looks. Next step is, you can use any brown you want, any dark brown. I'm using this e.l.f. mini palette. Just take any dark brown, and I take a nice angled brush. This is the Rufa Beauty RB04. So this is a really nice precise angle brush, and I'm going to take it and I'm going to draw a liner. Now, I don't like a black liner when I'm going for a natural look. I don't think it just looks good on me. I like something which is very nice and smoked out. So I'm taking the angle brush and I'm being very precise with it, and I'm adding a very nice thin layer of that dark brown. You can see I'm just going to extend it a little more. See, liner is so soft, but it does make so much difference. Like, you can see this liner just again lifted this eye so much more compared to this one. So if you think like you applied too much, just go ahead with any clean brush and blend that out. So it kind of gives like, you know, that fake liner effect. Like, it's, it kind of lifts your eye, but you can't really see the liner, you know what I mean? And that's it. Like, that's literally what I do for the eyes. And sometimes if I, you know, I'm in the mood and I want to like go that extra mile, I go in with the same angle brush again and I do a little bit of catwing or that foxy eyeliner type of thing in the, you know, corner. Very, very light. Like, you don't want it to be evident. Again, very lightly. It just makes my eyes look really nice and elongated. That's literally it. That's what I do for my eyes. I'm going to go ahead and add a setting spray. I make myself drench in setting spray because I feel like setting spray is the one thing, like, no matter how bad or how cakey your makeup turned out, like, a good setting spray would just make everything blend in really well and make it look a lot better. So the setting spray is going to take about like 45 to 50 seconds to dry. The meanwhile, I'll heat. Next, for highlighter, I'm going in with this Balm Cosmetics highlighter. It's a very beautiful, very, like, you know, finely milled highlighter. Though it's a powder, it kind of gives like a very creamy effect on the skin. That's the reason I really like this highlighter. I'm going to take a random sheen brush. I'm going to add it on the cheekbone. I add very, very tiny bit of highlighter when I'm going out because little goes a really long way, and highlighter can look very weird in person if added too much because it exaggerates texture, and it can look like, if you don't have a good highlighter, it can look very glittery and not so appealing. That's it. Like, the tiny bit of highlighter just blended on the entire skin. It just adds that light sheen to it so that, you know, when I look in the side, I have that sheen, but it's not too much. Like, if you look at me directly, you would not see that, you know, there's a highlighter there, which is there separately. Like, I see a lot of people, like, I can literally see where their highlighter is starting and ending, and that's not a good look according to me. A little bit on my brow bone as well. Next, I think this is like my most favorite step to do because my makeup is not complete without this step, is inner corner highlight. So now if you want a more natural look, then you can go with something like this shade and add it in the inner corner to highlight. But I do like using a highlighter, you know, it's like a preference. If you want it to look more natural, then go ahead with a matte shadow. But I just prefer the highlighter, and you should see that I'm not adding the highlighter in like the center part. I'm adding it above because for me personally, when I do it in the center, it kind of like exaggerates the under eye and makes it look a lot more darker, because, you know, now this part is highlighted and this part is not, so it looks very messy. So I like highlight the top part. Again, if you want to make it look more natural, you can kind of keep blending it so that, you know, there is like a highlighted effect, but you do not see where the product is again starting or ending. I do the same on my brow bone as well, a little bit. I add a tiny bit on the top part of the nose, take my hand and soften it up. Next, I'm going in with mascara, and for mascara, I'm using this L'Oreal Lash Paradise. First, before going that, make sure you curl your lashes because it makes a huge difference. Curling your lashes just helps mascara to lift and curl your lash even more. Properly take my time and apply it. All the lashes I move in the direction I want them to be. Like the end wala lash, I want it to be this side, so I apply it like this way. The center I want to be straight, so I apply it this way, and the inner corner on this side, so I apply it this way. So my top lashes are done. I applied mascara very, very thoroughly on all, literally every lash, and it looks really nice. But when it comes to bottom lashes, I don't do that because I feel like once I do that, all the lifting game which I just did kind of goes away, and it makes my eyes look droopy because kind of you know, weigh my eyes down in some way. Now, of course, if I'm wearing false lashes, then I probably apply mascara for lower lash line as well, because the false lash anyways going to dominate the lower lash line, and you know, it's going to anyways look still lifted. But when it comes to only mascara, then I don't do that. So what I just do is I take a tiny bit, like I just wipe off everything on it, and I just like add a touch of it. I just don't leave it bare because it kind of looks a little odd. I just add a tiny bit of it. I really hope you're understanding what I'm saying, because it's just like, you know, playing with your highlights of your face, like which looks better, which does not look better. Like, I've been doing this for a while, so I know what suits my face. Like, if I do apply a lot of mascara on the lower lash line, I don't really like how it looks. Now finally, we just have lips left, the Lenfer Beauty lip liner. Next, I'm going in with this K-Beauty matte lipstick. Finally, I just added kajal on my top lash line and a little bit of gloss on my lips, and I'm done. So yeah guys, that's it. That is the finished look. I really love this look. Every time I do it, I feel so good. Just makes me look so put together, and I feel really good anytime I do this look as well. I know this is something which does not fail me. No matter which outfit, any place, any time, I can always do this and feel the best. Yeah, and before going, there is one thing. So if you've stayed till here, then you know we are true love, and I have a really special giveaway for you guys. So I hit 50,000 subscribers, like I told you in the beginning of the video, and I wanted to do a giveaway for that. So I have two really beautiful hampers of makeup, really good makeup, and you guys can enter the giveaway if you want to win that. All you have to do is make sure to subscribe to my channel, ring the notification bell, comment down when and how you found my channel or why you like my channel, and also leave your Instagram ID in the bottom so that I can contact you if you win the giveaway. So yeah, thank you so much for always you know, loving and supporting. It just means the absolute world to me. You guys are really sweet, and thank you so much for watching till here. I hope you guys enjoyed it, I hope you guys liked it, learned something out of it, and that's it for this video, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.